out with just one side, and then we'll move on. Make sure you reach him. Move. Same side. So as it is, now change hands here. So you're not skiing from the other side. Skis on the same side, then you change hands. Then you move to the other side. As it is. Last one is second, but this is not next. You're doing it right now. That's the next one. Next one we're doing. Right now, we're stepping back. Understanding the distance, making sure you're not striking the air. You can just exercise. That's all right. So next we're going to work on just keeping that sticking in a slightly different opening. Actually, that's a very good exercise. Back. Try to keep that feeling. Be very careful if there's a gap. Go very slowly. Other side will feel more familiar because it's like the variation of Sancho 1 part 1, right? That connection between our weapons is what we're working on. But there is no gap. Exercises you do the one-handed, even though it's not that, right? I guess it's not that. But the feeling of your body moving with the weapon. And just move to pull like you would for the beginning of round 3, part 1. But even though he's going to pull out, we're still going to be content. That heavy connection is still there instead of, or, right? So that there's no gap, even when he pulls out. Still, you should be able to see a visceral connection between us.